Hello Boss Babes and Bosses out there. So in this video, I'm going to share with you the basic tools that I use for my clients and my team use to manage our social media accounts. So if you are an aspiring or newbie freelancer or an aspiring newbie social media manager and you are overwhelmed, kung ano yung mga tools or apps, software na gagamitin nyo to handle clients' account or even just your own account, then I guess this video is for you. Just keep on watching. So the first thing talaga na always nyo tinatanong, papa one-on-one call or yung sa workshop natin, and even sa mga interns, always talaga nila sinasabi na, you know what the hardest part is to come up with content, topic, kung ano daw yung ipopost na lang sa social media accounts ng clients na lang. So, yun yung pinaka-challenging na part, ang pag-come up ng content ideas. So, I've already created a video for that. Itong video na to, you can watch that video for the detailed explanation kung paano gamitin yung mga tools and ano yung mga ways na pwede nyong gawin din. But you know what? The 6 tools, the best way talaga siya to get an idea kung ano yung ipo-content nyo. So, nag-mention ako dito ng VidIQ. The second one is to source the content ideas sa Facebook groups. The third one, yung keywords everywhere. The fourth one is Quora. And the fifth one there is answerthepublic.com. And then saving content ideas sa mga social media platforms mo like. If you have a Pinterest, I really like Pinterest. Maraming mga content ideas ko nag-generate from there. Even sa Instagram, sa Facebook din. So, ayan yung mga sa social media accounts lang. And I really, really encourage you to watch this video here kasi in-explain ko doon kung paano nyo siya gamitin or paano nyo siya gawin. So, that's that. Okay, now, let's say meron na kayong content ideas. So, the second thing now is kung saan kayo kukuha ng mga graphics. Kung saan kayo kukuha ng video clips. Kung saan kayo kukuha ng photos. Sometimes, the client will provide the photos. Especially, ha, if physical product siya. Or, meron silang physical store talaga, physical office talaga, or something ganun. But yung mga kadalasan, mga startup pa, they don't have photos. So, you have to source photos on your own. Or even video clips. Then, sometimes then, yung mga small to medium business owners, wala din sila masyadong budget pa to buy mga premium photos, mga premium video clips. So, you really have to be resourceful as a social media manager. Ang always ko talagang naiisip pag mga free stock photos and free stock video clips is yung Unsplash, Pexels.com, and then Pixabay. So, these are the 3 main websites talaga na pwede kang makakuha ng mga high quality video clips and photos for free. So after that, meron ka ng content ideas and you know na where to get mga high quality free stock photos and videos. The next thing naman that you need to know, if you still don't know though, ang tool na gagamitin mo for graphic designing. Okay, feeling ko alam yun na. Kasi always akong gumagawa ng tutorials for this one. And all of our digital products then is made by Go! Say it. Yes, lahat ng digital products namin, ginawa siya sa Canva. I cannot really emphasize Canva. Very life-saving siya, especially if you want a faster output and super good na. Kasi marami silang templates na pwede mong gamitin. You will just have to change the color, the formation, and the text, and even the pictures if you have your own pictures, even the video clips that you have. Technically and literally, drag and drop everything. So, yeah, I would highly recommend Canva. If you still don't have a Canva account, you can click the link below. You can sign up from there. Marami talagang nagagawa si Canva, hindi lang for social media, pwede din sa printing business yun. If you have your own physical printing business, what else pa ba? Infographics, even business cards, yung logo, pwede ka din mag-edit din ng videos. Yung mga simple intro videos, yung mga ganun. This is really good, not just for entrepreneurs, not just for freelancers, but for all siya na gustong gumawa ng mga creative designs, pero hindi masyadong techie, then Canva is the answer to your problem. So, yeah, thank you, Canva. No, this is not sponsored by Canva, but we always use Canva. And I can always promote Canva kahit hindi sponsored yung video by Canva. I also want to answer this one kasi meron ding nag-a-ask sa inyo kung paano ko nire-record yung screen ko. Before, I'm using Loom sa pag-screen record. If you want to learn how to use Loom, you can check out this video here. So yes, marami na akong mga tutorials sa mga basic tools na dapat yung malaman as a freelancer or as a virtual assistant or a social media manager. If you are using MacBook, I would highly recommend QuickTime. I'm using that one now. Pero meron din akong i-share sa inyo na iba din na I also like kung gusto kong merong mukha ko and hindi lang siya screen talaga. Yung may video ko na nagsasalita ako at saka meron ding screen record. So, I'm gonna share with you Screencastify. So, you are currently seeing my screen now. So, ito. You can just literally type sa Google Screencastify, screen video recorder. This is an extension na pwede mong i-add sa Google Chrome. I'm not sure if this is available sa Mozilla. You can research and try it if you are using Mozilla Firefox or Safari. I-add to Chrome mo lang siya. Though, na-add ko na siya sa Chrome ko. So, ang nakalagay dito is remove from Chrome na. If I'm going to click this one here, ito yung Screencastify. If you are going to click it, ipalalag in kayo first sa Google account niyo. Pero nakalag in na kasi ako. So, hindi ko na siya need na gawin. This is a good thing din kasi pwede mo sa browser lang yung makikita talaga. Isang browser lang. Pwede whole desktop and then pwede webcam lang siya. So, if we want double like meron siyang desktop and then embed din natin yung cam, you just really have to turn this one on here. And then press record. If you are not in a premium account, ang limit lang ng video is 5 minutes. If very short lang naman ako, if mag-explain lang ako sa client ko or meron akong flow na gusto ipakita sa kanya, ito yung ginagamit ko. Easier kasi siya isend sa client compared ng QuickTime. But if I'm recording for tutorials, hindi pwede na ikakat ko every 5 minutes, so I'm using QuickTime. Ang QuickTime kasi kahit ilang minutes or ilang hours, marorecord siya as long as malaki yung space ng laptop or computer mo. Nag-start ako mag-use ng QuickTime because of that. I guess QuickTime is just for MacBook or Mac. I'm not sure anong katumbas niya for Windows, but I know maraming apps na pwedeng pang Windows. But if hindi ganoon kataas yung record mo, Screencastify is good, and you can also use Loom if you want. Again, I have a video for that here. I will let you see this one. Like, hi. So, kita ko. You just have to click this or maybe just the window, but if the entire screen, just click that one and then click share. And then magre-record niya siya. So, that's that. That's how easy it is. Okay, nakaisip na tayo ng content. Kasi gumamit tayo mga tools, right? Meron na din tayo mga photos, mga video clips na din natin, diba? And then meron na din tayo edit for the photos. And then kung kailangan na yung screen recording, naka-record na tayo ng screen. Second thing that we have to deal with is the copy or caption. Merong tools na pwede makapag-generate ng caption. I will share it to you, but I would not recommend it that much. Gusto ko lang na ma-aware kayo na meron namang tools that you can use para mag-generate ng caption or copy. So, ang first na alam ko is yung copysmith.ai. This is a paid tool. Actually, yung client ko nag-subscribe nito and gusto niya na gumamit nito for us daw to create a faster output for the copies. I prefer to create my own copy compared to generating copies like this one. Pero yes, nag-subscribe si client nito before. By the way, hindi ko na siya client ngayon. Super guapo niya. Super guapo. I think early 2021 ko to siya na client. Pinagamit niya ako nito and I would say na yes, okay naman, but parang mas double time siya sa akin kasi though I'm just generating the copy, I will still make sure din kasi na yung na-generate is tama talaga yung data or yung information. Pwede din yung copy.ai, I think that is just for free. You are just going to put one yung topic and then yung tone ng topic na gusto mong ipa-generate sa tool na yun. That's very pretty easy to use, but then again, I would not recommend. You can use that one for yourself, but maybe for your client, especially if you are an aspiring a newbie freelancer that we really want to have a good feedback from client, mas okay talaga na ikaw talaga yung gumawa ng caption. And I would really prefer that you guys create a very informative and sure ka na tama yung mga information. Mas maganda kasi talaga yung merong catchy first liner, tapos meron talaga yung content ng body na gusto mong i-share. Tapos merong parang pa-conclusion na part, and then merong call to action after, parang may flow, and parang you are telling a story, something like that sa caption. Caption kasi will really change the game if you will optimize it. Kasi pag gumamit ka lang kasi ng mga caption generator, mga one sentence lang, two sentences lang, yung mga ganun, hindi siya naka-optimize talaga sa kung ano yung content na gusto mo, right? So, I would highly recommend that you watch this video here if you want to optimize the caption. I would really say na huwag kayong masad if you realize na tagal yung gumawa ng caption. Even me, matagal din ako gumagawa ng caption kasi I really make sure na madaling maintindihan yung content. content ko when it comes to the caption, and then if I want to share something maganda yung pagka-flow, it would really take time. Yes, it would really take time. Kahit ako, it's taking me so much time then. Pero as long as you keep doing it, magiging mas madali na lang sa'yo kasi nasanay ka na na gumawa ng ganun. So, just be patient for yourself, especially if you feel like, bakit ang tagal ko? Bakit naabutan ako ng one day just to create one caption? Masasanay ka din na magiging faster din yan. So, ayun. And, meron pa, when it comes to caption, for example, meron ka nakitang article and you like that article because it really talks about your topic. If you want to get that content, please, kung pwede lang, huwag talaga kayo mag-copy and paste. Kasi nakikita yan ng social media. Parang mag-detect niya na this is just a copy of this post or this article. So, we don't want that to happen. Ang mas mabuti yung gawin, pwede nyo i-paraphrase on your own or meron ding paraphrasing tools. A paraphrasing tools is that you will just copy the sentence or the paragraph that you want to paraphrase and then i-paste nyo doon sa paraphrasing tool and then mag-generate siya ng bagong parang pagkasabi. Or na-paraphrase siya. Pero what I would say here is that if you're going to do that, don't forget to put the source. Even if you paraphrase it, even if magkaiba na talaga yung pagkasulat, but the thought and the idea is just really the same. Sa kanya yun ang point of view, and then you are just sharing his or her point of view sa content mo. Hindi mababawasan yung skills mo or hindi mawawala yung pagkamagaling mo as a social media manager if you are just going to get mga insights from other people and then you are going to put credit or source. So, that's that. The paraphrasing tools na I would recommend, pero paid siya. Ito kasi yung tools na feeling ko the same talaga yung idea or content na ma-generate. Nakatry din ako kasi mag-paraphrase na super ang layo. Yung for example, yung pinaparaphrase ko is the cat is eating a fish. Yung the paraphrase is the fish is eating the cat. Something yun. I'm like, totally different na yun. Magkabaliktad na something ganun. So, I would highly recommend killbot.com and prepostseo.com. Premium siya. Kailangan ka magbayad. Pero meron, I think, trial, like, ilang counts of words ang pwede mong i-paraphrase for free. Pero meron din namang everything is for free. Pero ayun nga lang, magkaiba yung idea na sa original content. So, ayun, just be careful lang if you're going to paraphrase something. Kahit pa ma-premium siya na tool or for free siya na tool, always, always double check kung the same pa rin yung thought nung na-paraphrase. It's very crucial. Let's say, for example, that is for your client. Tapos nagkaiba yung content. Nagkaiba yung thought, di ba? So, we don't want that to happen. So, double check always the caption. Now, don't forget the best grammar checker. I know you also know this one. Kasi kasali to siya sa quiz na pinost namin. Ito. Maraming sumagot yan. Sa kahit anong platform, pa LinkedIn, pa Instagram, pa Facebook, maraming sumagot at marami talagang alam ng icon na to. So, therefore, maraming gumagamit nito. So yeah, don't forget to install Grammarly. Yes, I also use that one. Even if yung for free lang na Grammarly, yung gamitin niya, it's already good. But if you can afford for the premium one, then it's also better. And just make sure that the grammar is correct and the spelling is correct. At least naman, nag-check din si Grammarly. Especially again, if that post is for the client. So that's that. That's for the caption. I think the next thing that I'm going to share with you is how you are going to manage the project. I already created project management tools and tutorials. Yes. I already created that. Meron tayong Trello, meron tayong Asana, and meron tayong Airtable. Again, if you are a social media manager and you want your client to check your work, I would highly recommend Airtable for that. If you don't know how to use Airtable so that your client and you can check the content that you are going to share sa social media accounts na lang, you can check out this video here. I'm literally sharing step by step on how you can use the Airtable for your content management sa client nyo. And if you are just using a project management tool just really to track the progress of your work, yung mga tasks na need yung gawin, you can use Trello or Asana. But for me, I really prefer Asana, to be honest, for project management tool kasi mas dynamic siya and then mas flexible siya for my needs. Trello, that is good for beginners talaga, especially if the client is also beginner na hindi niya gusto ng mga complexities. Meron akong mga clients din na Trello talaga yung ginagamit namin because they don't want to learn any other project management tools because that is just a waste of time though. They just really want the very basic kind of project management tools that they can check from time to time and easy to understand. time. And I think the last kind of mga tools na kailangan nyong malaman if you're a social media manager, no, is the content scheduling tools. It's very, very helpful talaga na mag-advance kayo, mag-create ng content, tapos schedule nila to make sure na on time kayo mag-post and to make sure na consistent kayo mag-post. Especially if you're handling mga clients. I know there are a lot of content scheduling tools. And I've already created a video here, this one. Kung wala pa kayong budget or maybe the client still don't have a budget for the premium one, meron kaming list na kung ano yung pinakamagandang for free na tools for content scheduling. Especially if the business is still small to medium pa, hindi na yung pang-corporate talaga, yung malaki talaga. If pang-corporate na siya, meron na yung budget din. Kaya na nila magbayad ng premium just for the content scheduling tools. So, as what I have shared on this video, before talaga, Hootsuite talaga yung always namin ginagamit. Even ako, kasi yan yung tinuro ng client ko before. But then, as I go on sa mga social media management projects ko, ang dami ko nang na-try. Na-try ko yung Buffer, Planoly, Tailwind, Later. And one thing I realized, yung mga features nila just really the same, function nila just really the same. Meron lang mga edge-edge konti, yung mga unique features, yung mga ganun. And makukuha mo lang sometimes yung mga unique features kung naka-premium. So kung hindi naka-premium, hindi mo din ma-feel yung difference nila. It's just that the user interface na makikita mo, doon lang nakakaiba. But the functionality itself, it's just purely the same. So, kung meron kang alam na kahit isang scheduling tool lang, probably alam mo lahat kung paano gamitin ang mga scheduling tools. Yes, I would really say that. So, ayun, we've tried the Creator Studio, we've tried Hootsuite, but now we are using Social Chum kasi marami siyang features, marami siyang functionalities na binibigay kahit for free lang, hindi kami nagbabayad nito. And we are using it for all our platforms. So, maybe you would also want to try that one. Again, these tools na mga shinare ko sa inyo, maybe yung mga features nito is hindi tugma sa need nyo for your business. So I really want you to try tools na sa tingin nyo okay sa inyo. But as a small business owner and as a small content creator, yung mga tools na binanggit ko, okay ngayon, nagamitin. And as you grow your team, as you grow your company, your tools will also evolve. Hindi ka always magsistick sa isang tool lang. It depends kasi kung ano yung kailangan ng business mo. Kasi hindi tayo pwede magstick sa, ito na lang gamitin ko talaga. Kasi ito na yung familiar sa akin eh. Dito na ako magsistick. Kahit alam mo na mas better yung ibang tools. We have to evolve. We have to change something. If we can say we need to change it for a better process, for growing a team, for growing a business, yung mga ganun. If you think you need to step up your tools, if you think you need to step up your game, you need to step up your business, your process, whatever it is, just be open for changes. So, ayun, those are the tools for now that we are currently using. Maybe sa next year, iba na naman, and I will share kung merong nag-evolve or kung just the same pa rin. So, yeah, I would love to know the top 5 tools na ginagamit nyo as a social media manager. Comment that below because I also want to know about it. Kung meron ba kayong tools na hindi ko alam, I also want to check that one out kasi maybe better yan sa ginagamit namin and maybe we want to try something like that, you know. So, yeah, before I'm going to end this video, I would like to flex the words of my boss babes and bosses inside my group. Check this out. Would like to join our Facebook group, just research and ready to boss up Ibrisui, and don't forget to like our Facebook page and follow us on our Instagram accounts @Ibrisui and @BossaPH. So yeah, hope to see you guys on my next one. Bye!